Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna alhamdulillah. Nahmaduhu wa nasta'iduhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu. Amma ba'du. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Like I promise, inshallah, the continuation of the book. It's been quite some time. I've sent another episode. And I'm really sorry for that due to a lot of engagement. Inshallah, continuation of the book, aqeedah to come in the kitab wa sunnah of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Jamil Zainu, rahimahullahu ta'ala. Last week, if you have not forgotten, we stopped at where I was explaining this verse, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْتَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. The man answered the question that he asked, لِمَاذَا خَلَقَنَ اللَّهُ. Why did Allah create us? And he said, Allah created us what? To worship Him and not to associate partners with Him. I say one of the reasons is this verse and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that said, مَعَاتُ مُعَاذِ بْنِ جَبَلٍ حَقُّ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوهُ وَلَا يُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. That the right of Allah upon the slaves is that they should worship Him and not to associate partners with Him. This week, inshallah, I'll be quoting from a book to hear. Let us hear the interpretation of this verse. You know, Dama, we said the Qur'an and the sunnah based on the interpretation of their pious predecessors. So inshallah, I'll be reading from a famous book, Kitab al-Tawheed of Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and we'll hear the explanation that he has done of these verses, on this verse and this hadith. Before that, the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I would like to read the complete hadith. When I mentioned Ma'ad ibn Jabal, it is in short, but I would like to read it in full so that we hear. نعم. وعن معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه قال كنت رديف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على حمار فقال لي يا معاذ أتدري ما حق الله على العباد؟ قال وما حق العباد على الله؟ قلت الله ورسوله أعلم. قال حق الله على العباد أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا وحق العباد على الله وحق العباد على الله Allah يعذبه من لا يشرك به شيئا. قلت يا رسول الله أفلا أبشر الناس؟ قال لا تبشرهم فيتكلوا. أخرجه في الصحيحين الإمام البخاري ومسلم. From the companion of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه, he said, كنت رديف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I happened to be riding with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ala himarin, on a donkey. Faqalali, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, ya ma'adu, o ma'ad, atadri ma haqqu Allahi ala al-ibad? Do you know the right of Allah upon the slaves? Wa ma haqqu al-ibad ala Allah, and the right of the slaves upon Allah? Qultu Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam. I replied, Allah and His Messenger knows best. قال حق الله على العباد, the right of Allah upon the slaves, أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا, the right of Allah upon the slaves is that they should worship Him and do not associate partners with Him. وحق العباد على الله, and the right of the slaves upon Allah, Allah يعذب من لا يشرك به شيئا, that Allah does not punish whoever does not associate partners with Him. Allah does not punish who does not what? Associate partners with Him. The person who does not shirk, Allah is not going to what? Any punish him. Mana, he's not going to be in hellfire forever. Qultu ya Rasulullah. Oh, the Prophet said, afala ubashiru nasa. Why shouldn't I just go and tell people, make people excited about this? Qala la tubashiruhum. The Prophet said, no, do not go and be spreading it. Fayattakilu. They will what? They will just go and be reluctant. They will be reluctant in doing good deeds, and they feel all they have to do is not to do shirk with Allah Azza wa Jal, and that is all. Fayattakilu, as far as since that is not going to make them be in hellfire, always in the punishment of forever, always in the punishment of Allah, so we just be reluctant in doing good deeds. Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim narrated it. Al-Imam al-Bukhari hadith number 2856, and Muslim hadith number 30. That's in Kitab al-Iman. Inshallah. Fihi masail. Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he said there are some masail, bimana there are some, we can't say problems, but rather some things we need to take note of. Al-Ula, the first is hikmatu fi khalq al-jinni wal-ins. The hikmah, the wisdom behind the creation of the hue of the jinns and then the men. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created the what? The jinns and the what? And the men. Except that if you worship in Allah. So that is the purpose of creation. A lot of people spend the whole of their life trying to look for this purpose. What is their purpose in life? But see, in just this verse, Allah Azza wa Jalla has told the purpose of our creation. Because imagine a scientist creating a machine, and he say he just created this machine without a purpose. First, what comes? What a purpose comes? Then what? Then the invention. Look at what he say when Allah told the malaika, "Inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa." He said he is going to put a khalifa upon the earth. He has not even created humans. And they said, "What?" Atajallu man yusiri fa iskud. The moment Allah replied, he replied to them with what? Yani Surah Al-Baqarah, replied to them, "Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun." You see, before even Allah created the humans, he already had a purpose for the creation. So how can you as a human being have a purpose for creating a machine? And you just leave it that way, and you say you do not, why is it that you can't you create a machine without a purpose? So why, what machine will you even create from the first place? So that is Allah Azza wa Jalla has created us. I'm just trying to give you, to show you that, even among the humans, this is something that is strange and impossible. Then, walillahil mathalul a'la. I'm not trying to what? Equate this human, but so that we could understand what I'm going, the concept of purpose I'm trying to make us understand. The second thing, anna al-ibadata huwa tawheed, anna al-khusumata fihi. That the real ibadah is what? It's at-tawheed, anna al-khusumata fihi. Because it is that ibadah that has caused all the problems that all the prophets have gotten with. What are the problems that the prophets got with? Is worshipping Allah alone without associating partners with him. That is the main problem that all the prophets had. Look at this word that Allah is saying, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. That we have sent upon every nation Rasulan, a messenger, أَنِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, commanding them to worship Allah, وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ, and to leave الطَّاغُوتَ. الطَّاغُوتَ كُلُّ مَا يَعْبُدُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَيَرْضَى بِهِ. Al-Tawud is anything that is being worshipped besides Allah, and he accepts that worship because there is that condition, he must accept it. Like Nabi Isa alayhi salam, we can't call him a Tawud because he does not accept the worship that they worship him. Sayyidina Ali, for instance, will not take it. The likes of Abdul Qadir al-Jilani or Abdul Qadir al-Jili, those who are saying they are doing tariqatul Qadiriyya, we will not take it for them. The like of Uthman Fodio that some people worship, we will not take it. We can't call them Tawud because they have rejected this. What we have found from them is the rejection of this. الثالثة لتقتن أن من لم يأتي به لم يعبد الله ففيه معنى قوله ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد. Whoever does not come with a tawheed on the day of judgment, he has not worshipped Allah. It is in it that is the meaning of the words of Allah, ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد. You do not worship that which we worship. Now the kuffar, what is the difference between them and the Muslim? The works of khairat, they used to do it. They used to feed the poor, the needy, and the likes. A lot of them used to do things like that. But what is their problem? Atajalu alihata ilahan wahid, ilahan wahida. Like, are you going to put all the gods to be one god? That is their problem. Worshipping Allah alone was their problem. And because of that, the Prophet ﷺ was commanded to say, وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا عَبُدُ. You do not worship that which we worship. Bimana, we worship different things. We worship different what? Different gods. Because there is no way you associate what? Partners with Allah, and you will say what? You are worshipping what? You are worshipping Allah. No, you are associated partners with him. Because you do not really know him, you do not know his sifat. And not knowing the sifat of Allah Azza wa Jalla, his attributes, his names and attributes, and giving him those right of those attributes is what? That means what? You are worship, and you worship that which yani you are doing ibda'a of calling other than Allah, then it is not Allah that you worship, it's someone else. Now I will skip some because we have not mentioned some of what is concerned, I will just bring the problems or the explanation that is concerned with what we have read, the two verses and the hadith we read, and one ayah. Malin kaza athalithata ashara ma'rifatu haqqillahi alayna. This tells us the right of Allah upon us, which is what? To worship Him alone. Ma'rifatu haqqil ibara alayhi idha addaw haqqahu. And this also shows us the right of what? The right of the slave upon Allah when what? When we have fulfilled our own part. This key place we should take note. The right of the slave upon Allah, it is no one that made it composed upon Allah. It is He who wished to make it upon Himself. Al-khamisata ashara anna hadhihi al-mas'alata la ya'rifuha akthar as-sahaba. That this problem, a lot of the Sahaba does not know. That is why Mu'adh said, "Oh, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, why won't I just go and spread it and be telling them?" Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "No, that means a lot of them does not know it. Even amongst what? Among the Sahaba. That means Dama I Al-Imam Bukhari opened Sahih Bukhari Babu Ziyadatul Iman. That Iman is increased, and he bought this verse. Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Dinakum. Today I fulfill your religion. And he said, Idha taraka shay'an min al-kamal of one question. You want a chapter that Iman increases, and he said this verse that Allah said, yani Iman Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Dinakum. Today I fulfilled your deen for you. Imam Bukhari said, when explaining, said the context that the meaning of the verse that's in affiliation with the context is that as the wahi, as the revelation is being revealed to Sahaba, their iman kept increasing until the day that Allah revealed this, that their what iman is complete and their religion is what? Their religion is complete. So this is telling us that what, even amongst them in this time, they did not know this. So that means a lot of people now are unaware of this, that the right of Allah is not the main right that Allah, the reason He created us, and His main right upon us is not to what? Associate partners with now worship Him alone. No shirk. La ya'budu ma'allahi ilahan ghayru. Do not associate any partners with Allah. So whether you pray, salah, you do sadaqah, you pray, fast Ramadan, fast, do whatever good deeds you want. If you associate partners with Allah, it is not valid. Anna hadhihi nam jawazu kitman al-ilmi limashalati. When he said he wanted to go and show, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Do not what? Do not tell them." So that they did not what? They did not become reluctant. So there is a permissibility of hiding knowledge in certain people because they might have a misinterpretation of it. So he keep it away from them at that time. Istihbahu bisharat al-Muslimi bima yasurruhu. Istihbabu, it is loved. Al-mustahab, it is loved upon a person to be what? To be given glad tidings to the Muslim. That was what Ma'ath ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, he wanted to do. He wanted to give glad tidings to the Muslim so that it was, so that they will find things easy upon them. So don't always be, all you hear, all they want to hear for you is problems. Problems. Not giving the Muslim good news, something that will make life easy for them. So the scholars, the da'is, they must try to bring solutions to the problems of the Muslims so that it will be what? Easy for them to pass all those problems. The Muslims are in the problem, religious problem today, economical, social aspect of life. Every aspect of life they are having such problems. So we must all find, trying to find solutions and ways that will make it easy upon them. Naam. Al khawfu min ittikali ala sa'ati rahmatillah. The Prophet ﷺ feared for the Ummah that they might just go and be reluctant, or, "Oh, I will get the rahmah of Allah." No. That's why he say what? Do not go and tell them that they just become reluctant. Yes, they are going to get rahmah of Allah. Allah can still punish you even if you do not associate partners with Him. But one thing is, you will not remain forever in hellfire. قَلِ الْمَسْؤُولُ عَمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَعْلَمُ. In it, there is also an observation. There is also a lesson. That what the reply of the questioner, that is Ma'ad ibn Jabal, the one being questioned rather, amma la ya'lam, based upon what he does not know. What did he reply? He said, Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam. He said, Allah and his messenger knows best. Allah and his messenger knows best. Because the Prophet ﷺ was asking him, and he knows the Prophet ﷺ what knew the answer to that question. That was why he was asking. That is why he was asking. Now that Allah and his messenger knows best. So he said, جَوَازُ تَخْصِيصُ بَعْدِ النَّاسِ بِعِلْمٍ دُونَ بَعْدٍ. There's also permissibility on telling a particular group of people a specific hadith, specific teachings without telling another group of people who may misunderstand it. تَوَادِعُهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ لِرُكُوبِ الْحِمَارِ مَعَ الْإِرْدَافِ عَلَيْهِ. Allahu Akbar. The tawadi of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam upon climbing a donkey together with someone. Not today, most of how we see the scholars, how we see the da'is. They feel they are too big for that. If you go to some of the scholars' parlors today, you see you cannot even sit on a chair. While they're sitting on a chair, you have to sit down, which is wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam climbed a donkey with what? With someone else. A donkey and with someone else. This is showing what there is what? Prophet ﷺ was calm. He had tawadu. He does not have pride. That how can he be a prophet and climb donkey? May Allah Azza wa Jalla protect and guide us. Jawaz al-irdafi ala dabba. There is also the permissibility of what? Of climbing with someone. Riding along with someone upon what? Upon an animal. Fadila to Ma'ad ibn Jabalin. This also shows us the fadila. The esteem, the worth of what? Ma'ad ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu. Idha min sha'na hadhihi al-mas'ala. The greatness of this what? Of this lessons. We also show see that these lessons are what? Of great essence, because that's the reason of our creation. But here, I have to stop here. Inshallah, next week or next, not rather next week, maybe in the next video. So far, there has not been any questions, so there are no questions to answer. I will have to stop here and say subhanakallahumma bihamdik ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.